Welcome to Headline News 24/7. Please click like and subscribe. Breaking news out of California. This is really bad for all of America. Look what he said. During the May 21st airing of Tucker Carlson Tonight, Representative Eric Swalwell, DCA, defended his plan for a government-sponsored assault weapons buyback with criminal prosecution of Americans who do not comply, Breitbart reports. The Democrat from California, Representative Eric Swalwell, openly admitted that the plan is a forced buyback program on assault weapons. When Carlson bluntly said that plan is a forced government confiscation, Swalwell sidestepped and avoided the confiscation truth. I'm not calling for confiscation. What I'm saying is we should invest in the buyback, that we should restrict any weapons that aren't bought back to gun clubs, hunting clubs, shooting ranges. Keep them there, where it is safe, not on our streets. And if you are caught, just like, if you were caught with drugs or anything else, they have probable cause to go into your home and you have one of these weapons, yes, you'd be prosecuted. Swalwell describes an Armalite rifle, in an article he wrote in USA Today. Military-style semi-automatic assault weapon, an assault weapon, then, is a handheld weapon of war, capable of spraying a crowd with more lethal fire in seconds, and we should criminally prosecute any who choose to defy it by keeping their weapons. After a bit of back and forth, Swalwell said, "Why do you need an AR-15 to protect your house?" Carlson responded, "I don't know, why do you need one? You have them in your building where you work." Someone should explain to the self-entitled egomaniac that no such firearm exists and never has. The term assault weapon was created by the left to feed fear into the sheep. As RWT News explained after Hillary Clinton frothed at the mouth about banning assault weapons, read the entire article by clicking here. The assault weapons ban was a flagship measure of Clinton's husband's administration, signed into law by Bill Clinton in 1994 at the peak of the crime wave that was devastating U.S. cities. It was allowed to lapse in 2004, and since then has been a major fault line in the dispute between Second Amendment conservatives and gun control liberals over what to do with the ongoing carnage of mass shootings in the country. Hillary Clinton wants to abolish the Second Amendment and we the people's rights to own firearms, and she calls her movement the resistance and that all firearm owners are a national shame. Assault weapon is an invented term. In the firearm lexicon, there is no such thing as an assault weapon. RWT Intel report to combat the left's assault weapon propaganda. The AR-15 is the most common example of what are sometimes called assault weapons. But what does this term actually mean? AR stands for Armalite Rifle, which is the company that makes them. Prior to 1989, the term assault weapon did not exist in the lexicon of firearms. It is a political term, developed by anti-gun publicists to expand the category of assault rifles. The Democrats have been saying for years that they do not want to come take your firearms away. Yet their actions show that is exactly what they want and are pushing towards. What people need to realize is that they are bypassing federal laws, and at a state level, they are accomplishing it. This is why it is so vital to get the blunt truth out and wake people up to the blunt facts, so that we may push back against the plague of the left.
That was the news. We thought you might be interested in knowing about this. Please click like and subscribe. Thank you.